He said, I'm there to block it.
All right.
So that's what he does allow you to go through. You can handle it. So the word said these light afflictions are but for a moment.
Yeah.
So just know that what you're going through is just light, and it's just for a moment. But all you got to do is just hold on just a little while longer, because the Lord is my buckler.
Yes, right. He is.
They said in the horn of my salvation and my high tower. A tower is a tall structure, either isolated or built upon a larger structure. Because the Lord said, the reason I am your high tower, because when you're down low, you need something you can see. Because you know, if you're in a hole, Deacon, you might not can see the top of the ground. Why? Because you're down in the hole. So God said, if I'm a strong, a high tower, even in the hole, you can look up and see that your help is there.
All right.
Why do you think the word said, look to the hill from which cometh your help?
Yes.
All your help comes. Woo, I feel God in this place. All your help comes from the Lord.
Yes, God. Thank you.
So when you're down and out, just look at the Lord as a high tower.
Yeah.
Look up when the enemy tried to get you to look down.
That's it.
Keep your eyes on the Lord. Why do you think David said, my cup running over?
Yeah.
Cup means it. To see you up. So God says, if you just look up,
all right,
I bring you up. The Lord is my time. I'm about through. Y'all waiting on me to preach. I've already preached.
Come on.
David said, I will call upon the Lord.
All right.
Who is worthy to be praised.
Yeah.
So shall I save from my enemy. David was letting the Lord know that he thanked him, he loved him for delivering him from his enemies.
Yeah.
David was letting him know that he thanked him and he loved him for all that he's done for him. But notice what David did. He said, I called upon the pastor of the church.
Uh-uh.
I called upon the deacon to come see about me.
Uh-uh.
He said, I called upon my neighbor to come see. Now the word said, David said, I called upon the Lord.
Yes.
Why do you call on the Lord? Because he knows all, he sees all.
Right.
Yes. He's the one that can make a way out of no way.
Yes.
I can't make the way. All I can do is pray for you. But David said, I call upon the Lord.
Yes. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. But notice.
That's all right. That's all right.
David said, the sorrows of death compassed me.
Yes.
And the floods of the ungodly men made me afraid. If God is on your side, there's nothing that man can do to you. So why are we fearful about what man can do?
All right.
Why are we fearful about what they say? Yeah, you're going to lose your job because you ain't doing right. Yeah. What are you worried about? If God bless you for the job, he going to bless you and keep the job. So we can't fear man, because man can't do no more than God allowed to.
That's right.
Ask the devil that. See, when the devil trying to test old Job, he can do no more than God allowed him to do. The Lord is.
Jesus.
Now you feel in the bank.
Yes, sir.
David said, in my distress, I called upon the Lord.
Uh-huh.
This was blessed message and cried unto my God. And he heard my voice.
Yes.
Out of his temple, and my cry came before me.
All right.
Even into his ears. How many of you feel like sometimes when you're praying that God don't hear you?
All right.
But notice that when you cry to the Lord, he said, I hear you.
Yes.
God said, if you're crying out, I'm listening.
Yeah.
But notice, he said, in my distress, distress is suffering of body or mind, and pain and anguish, trouble, misfortune, a condition of danger or desperate need.
Yeah.
But when you're going through these things, you got to know that the Lord is. You got to know that the Lord is hearing your prayers, Deacon. It's not going up to the ceiling and coming back down in. You're living according to his word.
All right now.
I'm about ready to get out of the way. But the Lord said, you know how when your mothers know when you hear your child cry.
All right.
It's something about the cry that you know what's going on.
Yeah.
You know when they're hungry because of the way they cry.
All right.
You know when they're dirty because of the way they cry.
Yeah.
The Lord said, I hear your cry.
Yeah.
The Lord is, now you fill in the blank.
Yeah. Come on.
God is just what you need. Right where I'm here. I'm not so gonna preach, I feel it.
Right.
Behold, God is my helper.
Yeah.
The Lord is with them that uphold my soul.
Yeah.
Now the Lord is that spirit, and where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Yeah. Come on.
The Lord said, I am the Lord thy God. Out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. If you don't believe the Lord will bring it out, ask the children of Israel. Over in 2 Samuel, the 22nd chapter, the 2nd verse, David has said the same thing that we're looking at here in the 18th number of Psalm. And back then he said, the Lord is my rock. And my fortress. And my deliverer. But he was so good over to him in 2 Samuel that he made a song about it over in tongues. So when you're going through and things get good, just get your song in the spirit. Like, I need the old. I need thee.
All right, come on.
At that moment.
Yes.
So when you're going through, yes, know that the Lord.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Yeah. The 29th number shouts that he will restore my soul.
Yeah, yeah.
So this year God is going to restore me.
Hallelujah.